them, vote them. Yes, Rosemary.
Diane Hamilton, her brother passed away and begged to help me to ask if we could pray for the family.
Okay, so remember that.
Lewis Elliott, that his wife was diagnosed with breast cancer. She goes in for a surgery next week. And then they also put his mother into the hospital with COVID pneumonia. And she's on a ventilator. It don't look good. So that whole family needs a lot of prayer.
Amen. Yep.
Almost the same situation with my son-in-law, Mike Eslick. He's on a vent now and went in with double pneumonia. Last I heard, they have not done a COVID test, but they're treating it the same way. So he needs salvation and peace in addition to healing.
All right, so remember that. Yes. So remember that when you pray. Also, if you haven't heard Leroy, they've called in hospice for him. He made the decision, but they're taking him off dialysis, turn the ventilator, defibrillator off, and so keep Leroy and his family in your prayers. Of course, Stephanie McDougal, Ryan's wife, her father passed away this past week unexpectedly. So I know their family is going through that right now, so really lift him up to the Lord in your prayers.
Leroy passed away this morning.
Oh, well, just now found out. Leroy passed away this morning, so just pray for Barbara and them when you pray, and that God comfort their heart during this time. So, anybody else? If not, if you would, bow your heads with us. Dear my Father, we thank you, dear God, for your presence here with us today, and we thank you, dear God, that we know that you're in our midst and that when we call upon your name, that you don't only hear, but you answer our prayers. We pray for them, dear Lord, this lost loved ones, and we pray that you comfort their heart during this time. Help them, dear Lord, that might feel your presence, dear God, that you might guide and direct them. Be with these as mentioned, dear Lord, that's sick. We know there's a lot of it going around, and we just pray healing for each and every one of them. Ask you, dear God, to go with us to this service. Let us feel your presence. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, who's had a birthday in the past week we can help celebrate? All right, there, man, shot that hand. How old, buddy? How old are you? 14. Man, yeah. I'm not going to ask. Okay, all right. And Reg, he got it in both services. How, Reg, show them how old you are, buddy. Don't hide behind that cowboy hat. See, he's got fat from some of y'all here. All right, so let's sing off. Anybody else? All right. That right back there, too. All right. Let's sing to all four of them. Give them all for a big hand. Praise the Lord. How about anniversaries? Anybody else had an anniversary the past week we can help celebrate? Rodney and Shirley had one in the early service, been married 57 years. And he tried to act like it was all him. Yeah. What have we done there, Louise?
I'm trying to see you.
Oh. Where's your heart? I thought he's making eyes at Dutch, and I thought, hey, y'all have an anniversary or what? Now I understand if you can't see, I understand why you're married. Okay. Anybody anniversary? Anybody? If not, then everybody reach out there and get a songbook out and really sing out for the Lord this morning.
We're
going to
start this morning on page 182.
Thank you.
4:38.
Pray, dear God, that you help us, that we might spread your gospel, dear Lord, that each and every one might come into the knowledge of you as our Savior. Bless this offering in Jesus Christ we pray. Amen. You may be seated.
Amen. We're going to turn to 5:14.
see him in here. Right. Well, as you look around and you can see that, I don't know if it's the cold or the COVID or just, gonna sit at home and watch it live stream and eat in their pajamas and eat cereal, but some of them, that's where they're at. But anyway, we are glad that you are here. John's gonna start us off with a special song this morning. There you go.
You had this up high enough for Robert.
Hello.
Teddy, you wanna shut them back doors? Or somebody go rescue Robin?
Test one, two.
Oh, yeah.
I heard an old, old story, how the Savior came from glory, how he gave his life on Calvary to save a wretch like me. And I heard about his glory and precious blood. And I won the victory. Everybody say, the victory is Jesus, my Savior, forever. He sought me and he bought me with his redeeming blood. He loved me and I knew him and all the
victory in Jesus, my Savior.
gift is redeeming love. He loved me and I knew him, and all the love is to him. He loved me to victory, beneath the cleansing blood. Yes, he loves me to victory, beneath the cleansing blood.
And Kathy, don't stand up till I call your name. Amen. It's been a while since they've done one of those. Thank you. All right, I think they got a special number, so all of us is gonna listen. Been playing this morning. I think they've been working on one, so unless you've been practicing them, you head on down.
Me?
No, that's you. Well, they did an early service, and I wasn't sure you had.
I know.
Me and Milt was on the same deal in early service. I'm telling you what, I thought it was my cold, but apparently it wasn't. Been working on this, did an early service for us, and did a fantastic job. Donna's monitor speaker over at Dutch is busted apparently, so all that you hear is coming from that. So Dutch is going to take it home today and lay hands on it. Not now. So anyway, here you go. Milton.
He's in Roberts. There we go. Nothing we needed.
And you, Dean is in number 11, I believe. Try a little bit, Dean. And Bill, we got Bill, don't you? Dean is good at one hand behind his back.
Consider all the world thy hand.
Dean broke a string before early service, went home and got one, put it on there, and then broke it right then before he got started. So he did all that, like I said, one hand tied behind his back, so that's it. And I see by some of y'all's emotion that that touched you this morning, and praise God for that. If you have your Bibles, turn with us to Acts, the second chapter, the 44th verse. Acts, the second chapter, in the 44th verse. And all that believed were together and had all things in common. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we just ask you, dear God, right now that you anoint your word. Help us, dear God, that we might receive it, that we might have understanding, dear God, and that it might be an encouragement to us, dear Lord, just to walk as you'd have us to realize, dear God, how much that we need and each other means to us, dear Lord, and be supportive. Speak to our heart right now in Jesus' name, amen. If you go back and you think about the early church of Acts and how that God had brought the disciples, the Christians together, people that were being saved, and I often look back at the book of Acts and think about how much did God prosper the church. And in the beginning, you see that one thing that was there that was present that was so important. And if you go back to that 44th verse and go even farther to the 45th, it said, "In all they sold their possessions and their goods and parted them to all men, as every man had a need. And they continued daily with one accord in the temple, breaking bread from house to house, did eat their meat with gladness, singleness of heart, praising God and having favor with all the people. And the Lord added to the church daily such as to be saved." Now you think about that, and the scripture goes on, not going to read it all day, a little short on time, but you know, it says even 1,000-2,000 people was giving their life to the Lord. And when you look at the thing that they had in common, it was that they had one mind and one accord, singleness of heart, that they had all things in common. And so, in other words, when they come together, whether they wasn't coming together to show off or they wasn't coming together to promote one another, promote themselves, they were coming together to promote the cause of Jesus Christ. In other words, they were coming to church just for one reason, and that was to have church. You know, I really believe that we as a nation, we as a church, need to get back to come to church for one reason, and that's to serve God. Amen?
Amen.
Not to worry about everything else that's going on, but just realize that God has given us a sanctuary. He's given us a place that we can come together, and we don't have to worry about anything besides let's just get together, fellowship together, worship together, praise God together, and be built up together. Now, you go back in this, and I'm going to tell you all the way through, you realize that God was bringing his people together. There had been division, and there had been all the things from the crucifixion of Christ, and you understand, man, the people that was following him, how confused they were, and how they didn't understand everything. But God was making a prayer to the church that if you'll just serve me and look to me, that I'm going to bless you, and I'm going to prosper you as a people. Now, the Old Testament is full of types and foreshadows. In other words, the children of Israel was a foreshadow of the church. And we realize that when the children of Israel just had their eyes on God, they wasn't worried about everything else that was going on, all the foreign gods that was in the country wherever they were at, all the things that the people in those countries doing, if they didn't get sucked in with them, that God blessed the children of Israel. He prospered them in every way. Now, when they get off and get into other things, and there was always those times when bad things would happen. And I'm going to tell you, I still believe the Bible's true when it comes to whatsoever you plant, that's so you shall you reap. You know, if you're planting discouragement and discord, and I'm going to tell you what, it's going to come up in your life. It's going to come up in the church. But when we come together and we realize that we have all things in common, there's not one person here better than anybody else. There's not one person here worse than anybody else. Now, I know you want to sit around and say, "Hey, wait a minute, you must not have met everybody here." Huh? It's not true. I'm gonna tell you, well, I might not have met everybody here, but I'm gonna tell you, in the eyes of God, we're all the same. And if we're anything better, it's because that we've accepted Jesus Christ as our Savior, and because of his shed blood. That's all that matters. Now, to show you how that God wanted his people to come together, and you go back up in the early part of this chapter, and we all refer and think about the day of Pentecost and how the disciples was there. And in the third verse it said, "And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as a fire, and it set upon each one of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And they were dwelling through Jerusalem, Jews, devout men out of every nation under heaven. And now when this was noised abroad, the multitude came together and was confounded, because every man heard them speak in his own language. And they all were amazed and marveled, saying one to another, Behold, are not all these which speak Galileans? And how hear we every man in his own tongue, wherein we were born?" Okay, now understand what God did on the day of Pentecost. All the Jews, because of the feast of the Pentecost, they had come back together. And brother, they were all in one place, devout men out of every nation. And to explain this in a way I think we all here in Oklahoma can understand it, is the Jews was just like here in Oklahoma, the Native Americans. They were all Jews, but they were just like, you know, we want to point to the Native American, and we just think, well, they're all Indians. But you know, the thing about it is, every one of them, if you're a Cherokee, you have one dialect. If you're Choctaw, you have another. That's the same way it was with the Jews. But see, on the day of Pentecost, God said, we're not in division anymore. I'm bringing the church back together. So what happened on the day of Pentecost, and he points this out, they marveled, and they said, Behold, are not all these Galileans? The people that was preaching, they were from the tribe of the Galileans, if you will. And they spoke Galileans. But you know, the people that was there of a different Jewish part, different tribe, if you will, they heard these Galileans speaking and preaching in their language. Now look, don't be misunderstanding that. Brother, that was a gift of God, and I believe this with all my heart. Somebody asked me here a while back, well, do you believe in the gift of tongues? I sure do. And what the Bible says, if they dropped me off somewhere in the bush, huh? You know, first thing, I'd be looking for me a mule to get riding out of there, huh? But if God put me there to preach, and brother, I didn't know their dialect, the gift of tongues that's mentioned here in the Bible, brother, was they got up and preached in somebody else's language, and I'm going to tell you what, God can still do her today, amen?
Yeah.
Every one of them, and you say, well, what was the purpose of this? First of all, for the scripture to be fulfilled, and also to bring God's people together where they could understand it. I'll tell you what, sometimes we can come to church and not understand anything that's going on, amen? And I've been there with you. When I was young in the ministry, and they had this guy, Dr. So-and-so, and you know, I had done some studying under him and everything else, and he was. I mean, this guy was, when it comes to biblical fact and knowledge, I mean, he was definitely recognized in the world theologian. I mean, all these things. And so people got to schedule them for revivals. And you know, I thought, man, I'm going to go every chance I get. I just got to hear this guy, you know. Well, I went to a few different revivals that he was holding, and every one of them I'd go to, he'd get up there and preach, and I got to be honest with you, this old plowboy didn't have a clue what he's talking about. I mean, I kept thinking, but now I'll tell you what, anytime he said anything that I did understand, I'd yell amen, huh? Well, you know, I got to sitting there one evening listening to this guy preaching, thinking, wow, I'm not getting this. Well, then I got to looking around, and every time I'd amen, be the only other time the other preacher's amen, huh? I thought, well, they're not getting no better than what I am. Well, I can promise you, if you come to church here, I'm not going to preach over your head, huh? A lot of you probably had to bend down to get to where I'm at. But I'm going to tell you what, the gospel needs to apply to where you're living, amen? I can get up here and preach some things to you that like coughing in your ear. Maybe I don't understand, but I'm going to tell you this. We need to hear and understand the word of God. Amen? And that's what happened on the day of Pentecost. No matter what tribe they were from, they heard the word preached in their language. You see, with the Tower of Babel in the Old Testament, you remember that? See how it is? That's a trick. Anyway, they were all one language. And they got together and they said, hey, we're as intelligent God is. We'll just build a tower all the way to heaven. And the Bible says that God come down and confused their language. And that's where all the different languages, nationality, and all that started. God spread them out over the face of the earth. They couldn't all communicate because they had to leave off building the building. Well, guess what? On the day of Pentecost, God brought us all back together. He said, there's one tongue, there's one language, and let me tell you what that is. It's the gospel of Jesus Christ. Amen. You see, the gospel of Jesus Christ is not going to cause division. It's not going to separate us. It's not going to drive us apart like happens in so many churches. The gospel of Jesus Christ, that unifying language, brother, is here to bring us together as the church of Jesus Christ. Amen. Because they all got brought together. Souls being saved now. The church was added to daily. We want the recipe for revival. And who and why anybody ever thought revival meant having somebody come in and preach for a couple weeks. That's not revival. Revival starts right here in the hearts and souls of every individual. And brother, you let a people catch it, let a couple people get caught on fire. You know what, it starts spreading. Of course, you know, there's always going to be some say, well, just give them a little bit, they'll settle down. Huh? Man, we don't need pray people to settle down or wait on it. What we need to do is get excited with them. Amen? Amen. I seen one of these kids the other night. Some of you ain't going to like this, and I don't care if you do or not. Come running through here, and somebody said, don't run in church. I thought, man, I wish to God some of the adults would went with them, huh? Don't misunderstand that. I believe when we come to the house of God, we ought to be reverencing God. Amen? But I'm going to tell you this, brother. I don't want you just to sit there like a bump on a pickle. Huh? And let me clarify. I'm talking dill pickle. Huh? Because that's the way a bunch of us... know what he's talking about. I don't think he knows what he's talking about. Well, see, finally we're on the same page, huh? But I'm going to tell you what. I love the presence of God. Amen? I want the joy of the Lord, brother, not only I want it to consume me. Amen? And I want so much of it. You want to talk about being full of the Holy Ghost? I don't only want to be full of it. I want it running over, and some of it might splash on you.
Amen.
Hmm. Yeah, I know. Some of you... you know, just like old boy come into church and he was amen and praise the Lord. And, you know, after church they said, hey, we don't do all that here. He said, well, I just found Jesus. I'm just happy about it. And they said, well, we're definitely sure you didn't get it here. Tell you what, I want you to know this. I love you this morning, huh?
Amen.
And guess what? If you're right with Jesus, you got to love me too. Huh? If you're having trouble with that, I'm going to send Russell back here to hug you. I thought this morning, here come Russell. I thought, I'm just going to tell him I got the COVID. He don't care, see? I tell you what, you got the COVID. Russell, squeeze it right out of you. You know, church... I want you to know this. And I had a whole day with a topic I went to in early service, not going to make it there today. I'm going to tell you what, probably shouldn't have made it there in the first place. But you know, it's one of those things that when we come together, we can get sidetracked looking at everything else and getting so caught up in everybody else. In Romans, and I'm not going to go there, but it said, you know, don't judge lest you should be judged. You know, one of the biggest problems that keeps us from having all things in common in church is we want to look at everybody else and think, do you know about them? Mm. Huh? I come out of the store the other day. I'd been up here working, went down there to get me a much needed and deserved, you can amen this, Dr. Pepper. And I come out, there's a person called me and somebody else is leaving. They said, let me tell you. And I thought, I don't want to. Will they go to your church? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well, I'll tell you what, I don't need no news flash on somebody in this church. If I wanted to do that, I'd buy one of them little paper jailbirds, huh? Some of you take those things for family portraits, don't you? Don't worry about them now. I'm just joking. But if you do, Randy gets you out. You come back home to slick. Where here's the mayor. There's a cycle being, okay. But you know, here's the thing. I thought, I finally said, I'm not interested. And I know it made him mad at me. I tell you what, I thank God when he looks at me through the blood of the Lamb. Amen.
Amen.
I thank God that when I pray, he's never answered one prayer of mine in the name of Steve. Huh? And he never will. But when I pray, and I pray in the name of Jesus, by the shed blood of Jesus Christ, then guess what? Brother, my prayers are going to be answered. And if you know Jesus Christ, then me and you got all things in common.
Yeah.
Huh? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Whether you like to admit it or not, we blood kin. I mentioned this here a while back. You know, I kind of got one of them tests, you know, the girls got it for me. And I've been finding out who all I'm kin to. Woo! Who all I ain't kin to. That's been a blessing. But you know, I'm sure there's people on there found out they's kin to me and they're thinking, really? You know, you get all kind of surprised with them. Dwight and Marie, they're third cousins. Didn't know it till they got that test. No. Yeah. Father back than that. Come to find out on her mama's side, he's actually her grandpa. Sorry, guys. She still loves you. As her husband and a cousin. Every one of us in here has got to realize this, that when we come to know Jesus Christ and the free pardon of sin, guess what? We're a new creation. Old things are passed away. God's not going to bring them things up. The devil will, and you know what he brings them up most of the time for? To cause division. To make us look one way or another to everybody else. But I'll tell you what, when you look at people in this church, you ought to see them like God sees you through the blood of Jesus Christ. I thank God I've been changed. I've been converted, amen, from one lifestyle to the other. And when we come together as a body of Christ in one mind and one accord like they did in the book of Acts, you know what there's going to be? There's going to be blessings instead of cursing. There's going to be people come together to love one another, embrace one another, and show that. And guess what? As Donna comes to piano, I believe with all my heart, just like God added to the church, and I know we look around and through the COVID, and we, you know, every time the COVID spikes, you see things and you know, the seats, more empty seats and everything like that. But I'm going to tell you what. God brought his people through everything else, and God's going to bring us through this. Amen?
Amen.
And I'm looking forward to it. I'm looking forward to the point that this place is filled back up, and we get out there and we fill that up. And God's going to bring it to pass. The only way that it can happen is the same way it did in the early church of Acts. When we quit worrying about who somebody was or what they've been, we quit worrying about social levels. We start quit worrying about, you know, where you come from, the ethnic group, or anything else. None of that matters. All that matters is that the blood of Jesus is applied to your life.
Yeah.
And if it is, guess what? No matter what you think, we have all things in common. Nobody's better than anybody else. We're all the same in the eyes of God. As you stand with us this morning, I want you to embrace that. As Donna just sings a couple of verses, I'm going to ask you to bow your heads and just pray, God, help me to see my brothers, help me to see my sisters through your eyes, through the eyes of God. And realize, dear God, that as your children, we're all the same. We've all been blessed. We've all been heirs and joint heirs of Jesus. Let God just bind us together in his love. in his fellowship, not worrying about anything, but loving one another and embracing one another. And whoever comes through those doors, showing them the same grace and the same attitude that God has sent, shown to you. So you pray that this morning. Let God hear your heart's prayer today. Show one another, and when I say show one another your love, I don't mean a bear hug. I mean just in the way we present ourselves to one another, the way we embrace one another and show one another. But by his blood, we are all redeemed. We're all part of the family of God. Don't forget tonight at 5 o'clock, the ladies will be having their secret Santa reveal. That's at 5 o'clock, and bring all kind of soup, chili, anything you want to bring with you. And they encourage you also to bring a little cupcake
muffin tin.
Muffin tin. I stand corrected. How many of you have a muffin tin, John? Oh, she said you did have.
Yeah, we did.
Okay. You stand correct. But apparently she's not making you very many muffins, or you'd know that. Now, see how it come back on you? Okay. Okay, let's move on. But bring that out, and they put all the soups out and everything. You can come by with that little muffin pan and taste all the different soups. And everybody, all you ladies are invited to that, whether you were in the Secret Santa reveal or not. But if you were in that, bring your last gift out tonight. Good time of fellowship, 5 o'clock tonight. Don't forget, on the bulletin board back there, you want a new hoodie or a long-sleeve T-shirt, make sure you get signed up on that. The Valentine's banquet's the 13th of February. Be at 5 o'clock on a Sunday night. And so if you're going to come to that, make sure you sign up on that list too so we can get a count for the cater. Everything's catered in. All you got to come that night is a way of the church giving back to the body. So everybody come out and enjoy that on Valentine's Day. In other words, guys, it's a cheap date for you, okay? So, and ladies, it ought to be a blessing to you, huh? Somewhere besides Taco Maho. Okay, anything else before we dismiss? If not, bow your heads with us. We'll look to the Lord and be dismissed this morning.